Is it important for data scientists to have domain knowledge in a specific field? Hi, I'm Tomi Mester from data36.com, and in this episode, I will answer this question. As you might have heard from me many times, data science is at the intersection of three big fields: statistics, coding, and business thinking. And focusing on business thinking, we can break it further down into two big topics: general business sense. How do you approach a problem? How do you estimate return on investment? How do you prioritize? And so on. And domain knowledge, specific expertise in a given field like online marketing, automotive, logistics, biology, health, or anything else. So, domain knowledge. It is important for sure. You know, you can't come up with meaningful conclusions and drive results from your data science projects if you don't know the business you are in. That's sort of self-evident. But how important it is exactly, and how much domain knowledge should you have before you apply for a specific data position? I will explain everything. Let's start with the obvious. If you already have the fundamental data science skills and good domain knowledge in a specific field, that's a huge advantage. Also sort of unique. Let's say that you have learned Python, SQL statistics from online courses, you have a good sense of business, and you are fascinated with cars, or even better, you have a college degree in automotive engineering already. And you have your lucky day too, a few entry-level data scientist positions open up at BMW, Tesla, Toyota, right in the city where you live. Perfect match. Awesome. You just send in your CV, and you are practically hired. But the thing is that quite often you will apply for data positions in a different domain than you are good at right now. Maybe there are no openings in your preferred domain in the city you live in. Maybe you want to try something new. Maybe you realize that you could work on more exciting things in other fields in the long term. Or maybe you don't have domain knowledge in any fields yet, because this will be your first job. These are realistic and pretty common scenarios. So, if you recognize yourself, don't worry, just keep listening. Here's a common case. You are already an expert in a given domain, you want to stay in this domain and become a data scientist in it, but you don't have any data science skills yet. And I have good news. That's the best and easiest position to be in. Why? Because the majority of the things you will have to learn in this case are hard skills. Here's a concrete example. Let's say that you are a chemist, you have a chemistry degree, and 5 years experience at a pharmaceutical company where you have worked as a research assistant, you haven't worked with data yet, but you have a strong domain knowledge. That's awesome, because to move towards data science, you will have a pretty straightforward roadmap. Learn SQL, learn Python, learn statistics, and so on. I won't go through the whole roadmap here, but if you want to learn more about it, check out my free mini course called How to Become a Data Scientist. Find the link in the show notes. But the point is that yes, learning coding and statistics is challenging. It will take a lot of time and energy from you, but it's still not as difficult as getting 5 years experience and domain expertise in the pharma field, for instance. In other words, the most difficult part is already done. So if you have domain knowledge in a specific field already, you want to stay in that field, and you can learn data science-related hard skills, you will stand out compared to others when applying for positions. Unfortunately, it's much trickier if you have just finished university or high school, especially if you have a degree that's not domain-specific, like business or statistics and so on. In this case, your best chance is to look for internships and be upfront about your lack of domain knowledge. I mean, it's totally okay, but it means that the first few years of your career will be about learning, which, by the way, is totally normal if you are freshly graduated. You shouldn't focus on salary yet, but on learning about one specific industry. And parallelly, you can also learn about data science either from books and online courses, or if you are lucky, on the job from mentors. After a few years, you will find yourself in a similar position as our dear chemist in the previous example. And just a quick tip here, if you have choices, pick an internship in a field where you either see yourself in the long term or that's broad enough to let you reposition yourself into another domain later. After starting to work as a data scientist, it will inevitably happen that you will want to change domains. It happened to me too. First, I worked as a data analyst for a presentation software company, then I worked as an analyst for e-commerce businesses, then I worked as an analyst for a fintech company. These are all different domains, but they are not too far from each other. For instance, at my first job, at the presentation software company, I was a dedicated analyst on the customer and marketing team. And while the main domain of this company was design and presentations, on that specific team, I picked up some online marketing knowledge too. And that became handy later when I started to work with e-commerce companies. And at e-commerce companies, a part of my job was to analyze the efficiency of different online payment solutions, and that knowledge helped me to get into the next domain, to a fintech company. The point is, it's totally possible to change domains throughout your career. In fact, it's easier than you would think, but you can make the transition smoother if you choose a domain that is a little bit related to your previous ones. And before I finish up with this video, I want to talk about the pro level where not having domain knowledge can become an actual advantage. I have a few senior data scientist friends with 10 plus years experience at a data consulting company. They are working on various projects all the time. Sometimes they have to predict real estate prices, other times they try to detect online advertising fraud, and they get involved with agriculture-related data projects too. So they work for so many different industries that it's almost impossible to be good at all of these. I recently had a discussion with them on this topic, and do you know what they said? That they actually prefer not having domain knowledge when they get started with a new project. They are such experienced data scientists already that they can connect the dots without in-depth expertise in a given industry. And on the flip side, they can take advantage of the out-of-the-box thinking by not knowing the domain-specific benchmarks, best practices, and so on. As they put it, in 80% of the cases, we only discover heuristics that the client already knows without analyzing the data. In 15% of the cases, we discover something that's just noise and won't be useful, but the other 4-5% of our findings are those out-of-the-box findings that can be the real game-changers for our clients. Maybe we wouldn't have found these if we weren't an external new set of eyes. So not having domain knowledge can be an advantage too, but let me stress that here we are talking about senior data scientists with decades of experience under their belts. Okay, I hope that now you have a better idea of the importance of domain knowledge in data science. It's a huge advantage if you are an expert in a specific field. If so, you can get hired in that field, and later on, you can smoothly transition yourself into other related industries. And if you don't have any specialization yet, you can always get started as an intern and spend the first few years learning. But with that being said, this is the end of this episode. If you liked it, please subscribe, leave a rating or a comment. And remember, the best way to get notified about new episodes is always the Data 36 newsletter list, the only place where I really communicate to my audience right now. You can subscribe to it at data36.com/newsletter. And hey, if you do so, you will get access to a lot of free learning materials too, including my free mini course called How to Become a Data Scientist. Thank you for listening. I'm Tommy Mester from data36.com. Until next time.